Welcome to Big Laws Official. Today is recovery day. So today we're just kind of having like a recovery day. I've kind of made Wednesdays my recovery day now. I'm off to see Angus Nixon, who is my chiropractor in Bristol. I haven't seen him for a few weeks. Obviously I just got married and was in Jamaica for 2 weeks. And then before that, the World Team Championships and then World Strongest Man. So I basically had 5 or 6 weeks away from the gym with no treatment. So I'm kind of looking forward to today. I expect to fail a few of the tests he'll do on me. But that's all good because hopefully he'll treat me and I'll feel better afterwards. Then after we see Angus, we're off to see my brother in Cheltenham, who's kind of, he's pretty much my coach now, helping me with my mobility and conditioning and fitness work. It's a beautiful day, so we'll probably be out on the track, which is quite cool. I like training outside when it's nice. And then later on, I'm meeting up with a new physio today. Hopefully he's pretty good. He's been recommended to me pretty highly, so we're gonna go see him. He's booked me in for an hour and a half appointment. He wants to go through all my kind of injuries from the past and competitions that I've got coming up and come up with some kind of plan to help make sure I'm in peak performance for those. So yeah, it should be a fun day. Have a bit of feeder. Basically an emo. An overgrown emo that eats too much. Okay, so we just come out of seeing Angus in Bristol, on our way to Cheltenham now to see Harry. Angus is my chiropractor. Haven't seen him for about 6 weeks due to just being away and then competing at Worlds and World Team Championships, etc. And I knew I felt pretty bad. It's amazing really, because since he's been treating me, it's really helped my recovery, it's helped my performance. And I noticed having that 6 week break, I didn't feel as good in myself. He does a various degree of tests to check which muscles are firing, and I failed about 8 of them today, which is a record for me. But it's a good thing because, you know, I've noticed it in training last week and this week. Benching this week, my kind of left arm felt a little bit weaker. Last week on squats, I felt like I was pushing my knees forward a little bit. And when I kind of go and see him, it almost explains why. You know, both glutes weren't firing, so I obviously wasn't sitting back into a natural position like I should do. My left arm was really rubbish with a few of the tests. And he treated me, and you know, I already feel a lot better. So I'm looking forward to seeing how squats go tomorrow. I find him brilliant. You know, since he's been treating me, my training's improved so much. I've kind of really got to that stage where I'm progressing again, hitting PBs, and feel like I'm getting better. So, you know, for me, he's a huge part of my recovery and of my training. Next up now, we're on our way to Cheltenham. I don't actually know what Harry's got planned for today. I usually focus on mobility and conditioning work with him. We're just into a new training program now, so I'm hoping it's nothing too hard today, especially as the weather's quite nice. The temperature's going up already, and we get to train on a training track, which is nice. Nice to train outside. But looking forward to it. I've kind of changed a lot of things for this next kind of training program, training camp for Manchester. I'm looking forward to it. Eating a lot more, so we're going to have to take a break in a second and get some food. And then we'll be back with Harry in Cheltenham. Train outside in the sunshine today. Just warming up now, just a bit of foam rolling, just to get any kinks out of the muscles. I find it quite useful before I do any form of training now. Been way too lazy the last few weeks, so just easing myself back into it. Okay, guys, we're here in Cheltenham today. This is my brother Harry. He's kind of helping me with my training, pretty much coaching me right now, particularly with mobility and conditioning and fitness side of things. So I'm here to see Harry today. Do you want to tell guys what we're going to do today?
So today we're going to do a little bit of cardio, just getting warm, and then we're going to look at some mobility mainly today.
It's pretty basic stuff right now, isn't it? We're kind of first 2 weeks back. It was my first session actually back with you since we've been on holiday.
So I'd imagine he's going to be pretty tight today. So we're going to have a look at his hips area. We're going to have a look at the hip flexors, the TFL, glute meads, areas he tends to be pretty tight in, which affects his a few of his lifts. So it's going to be mainly lower body today. Probably save upper body for another session or maybe next week. Just want to get him doing some lower body mobility drills.
Cool, let's do it.
So at the moment we're just doing some gentle cardio, getting Lawrence's temperature main reason we're doing it is we're trying to get more calories into Lawrence, so hoping just sort of 20-30 minutes a day is going to get his appetite up, really. So that's one of the main reasons we're looking to do it. Yeah, Lawrence has really struggled to get the calories in the past, so far so good. So we'll see how it's your weight come back up since.
Yeah, I've weighed this week, but I put 7 pounds back on him.
Okay, so that's good. We're looking to get you around 165, 170 kgs, and then possibly cut down a little bit for Worlds. So trying to get strong and big, and then we're going to bring the conditioning in for Worlds.
Heart tissue mobility.
Yeah, shoulder mobility is a big thing. Okay, struggling to get on my
short lacking. And he redid it like 4 times in a row.
Yeah.
And then
did it come back?
Yeah, couldn't budge with it. Every Wednesday, before I come to you, I'll be back. By the time it comes to the hold,
I've got a couple of sort of static stretches.
Quads tight. Step towards the outside hand. Try and keep the back leg long, okay? Reach up so you just get your upper back moving as well. Okay? Just try not to let that knee trail to the floor. Both sides. Yeah. Good, and you're trying to get as close to your hands as you can. And that's what we're trying to improve. So Lawrence is quite far away at the moment, we're trying to get closer to his hand. Hold one position, so come through, hold. So if we straighten this back, then we're opening up the quad and the hip flexor here. Then we'll open up the adductor a little bit here as well, and just getting some thoracic sort of rotation through there.
Right, yeah.
Which Lawrence enjoys. Coming into a glute stretch now, an area Lawrence tends to get very tight in. Okay, we're just going to sink back until we feel a stretch. So we feel that stretch in that glute there, and then back. Again, keeping it dynamic, trying to sink a little further each time. Now hold that, Lawrence, so you don't slide back. So hold that, so you keep your hands there.
Yeah.
That's something really really looking to work with Lawrence, the mobility in his glute med, going into his TFL, his outside quad, all those internal rotators, tends to get pretty tight on. Squeeze your glutes, okay? Try and get some extension in that upper back. Yep. Squeezing your glutes, and then I'm gonna walk it back into the calves, okay? So,
your back wants to stretch in the calves.
Bring it back through. Straighten one leg. We're just going to go up and down with the leg, stretching the hamstrings. Lawrence has got obviously very big, strong quads and hip flexors here, but they tend to get pretty tight, which sometimes stops him getting through with his glutes. And you'll see on his deadlift a lot of the time, he struggles with his lockout, so it's something we're trying to address. So we're trying to get his glutes firing. And also, if I come in here without his lower back extended, if you push into me, Lawrence, because we want extended his hips just with his glutes, we don't want him overextending his lower back as well. So if he just pushes into me there, that'll take the lower back out of it. You find he might not come as high, but now we're seeing sort of the truth in terms of what he's got with his hip extension. Good. So loosen off the lower back.
Knees, chest,
sit up.
Legs go wide.
Knees, chest, sit up.
Legs go wide.
Training, so if we can do this before sort of your next comp, that would be progress. Like you would at school when you're a kid, when you try and sit cross legged. So it's against the same. Good. And just doing that, Lawrence probably feeling a big stretch up in his hips here.
Flexible man. There it is.
I was actually shocked when Lawrence first session here. Working the general club there. It's quite shocking. But it improved as we went on. And the big event we saw was the sort of atlas stones. Lawrence used to have to go so wide where he couldn't get down to the stone. He just couldn't get any power in that position, so he managed to bring it in a little bit and get down further to the stone, which is, we'll be doing a drill in a second to try and improve that still. And stone was a bit better.
Yeah.
Stand up, yeah.
Okay. Now pushing the knees out, trying to get the feet facing forward. Okay, keeping hold of the dumbbells. Straighten out the mental hamstrings. Okay. Back into the squat. Open up. See, this becomes quite a similar movement to when he's doing the atlas stones. So he's keeping hold of the dumbbells, trying to anchor his hands down there, because obviously we want his hands on the floor with his feet in a powerful position, not in a sumo position out here, which is what he has been doing in the past. So as you bring the hips up, you should start to feel a stretch in the hamstrings, you should feel it come into the lats.
A lot of trust involved in this stretch.
Yeah. Liz wouldn't be happy if I let go of this.
I wouldn't be
or
happy.
Or maybe she would be happy. Give her a break. Okay, now squeeze that right glute and brace your abs, okay? So you're not overextending the lower back. And every time you squeeze that right glute, you should feel more of a stretch. Just put it on and off.
On and off. Good.
Stay braced, keep that rib cage down. Where you're feeling it? Good. And where you're feeling the stretch? Okay, so really up in the hip flexor area.
In the quad as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. That tightness in the hip flexor is going to be stopping Lawrence getting the most out of his glutes. So we want to try and open this up and work it. With a sort of hip thrust or a glute bridge or something of that nature. Equipment will work with Lawrence because he's not the same as normal people. Box will probably go flying. second, get the Lawrence glutes working, just try and set him up first. So come to the top position. So we want his heels probably just underneath his knee, so probably forward slightly. Okay. I want you to keep looking at that opposite wall again. We don't want the lower back doing the work here, we just want him locking his glutes. So just drop your glutes down, hips down, now come up and lock. Just feel them lock.
Yep.
Okay, and down and come up and lock. And you're good. Dropping hips down and squeeze the glutes. To counteract the tightness of his hip flexors, we're trying to just work his glutes. I mean, to really challenge them, Lawrence is going to need a lot more weight than this, but it's just a mobility session today, so we're just trying to fire them and get them cueing. Find it more in the quads, maybe just take your feet out a little bit.
Come on, the hamstring, and then it starts going on that one.
trying to hurt my back. I just like, right.
The same thing. Thing I'm doing at the moment, I feel, to help me progress.
Yeah.
We've changed quite a few things with my training and nutrition and all sorts of things, but lack of mobility work
is the least as well.
Yeah, the lack of mobility work that I've put in over the years has, you know, been detrimental. It's caused injuries, and it creates weaknesses in certain positions. Obviously, I have a lot of power, but if you can't get into the right position, then you're not going to be as effective. So. Is something now we're taking quite seriously to improve, and you can see at the moment it's still shit. It was improving before Worlds, it was getting better.
What, 5 weeks off?
Yeah, 6 weeks off, to be honest.
6 weeks off, he's tightened up a little bit.
Going on holiday, so now lots of hard work. We've kind of added in extra mobility work in the week. I mean, I'm doing stuff on my own every day, but because I have so much muscle mass at the moment, I'm not quite where I need to be. There's certain movements where you can see at the moment I'm almost, Harry's holding me in position.
So most people would be able to bring their...
You can see as soon as he lets go, it starts just...
Bring this knee to their chest. So Lawrence, just fly back, try and bring this cheap knee to your chest. It's just not happening. Most people bring it up and hold it. So not most people.
I'm not most people, that's true. So I've been performing at, you know, world level with shit mobility, so hopefully when I get some decent mobility, I wouldn't even call it good, just relatively decent, hopefully it's going to help me quite a bit.
And we haven't really touched on the overhead today, but the overhead mobility is going to help Lawrence as well. He's not a massive strict presser, so he's someone who needs to use his legs to get a big weight overhead. I mean, we're trying to work his strict press as well, but if he can improve his... Do you know what I mean? You won't see an Olympic lifter with poor shoulder mobility. So that's another area we need to work on. And they'll work together. As his hip mobility gets better, his shoulder mobility will improve as well.
So happy. Right, we're all finished up now. Feel pretty good. I actually feel a bit looser now, so it's definitely working. Harry, just give us a quick recap of what we did today.
So we just started off with 20 minutes of pretty steady state, low intensity cardio, just getting in warm. Then we moved into some dynamic stretching. So we just focused on the lower body today. So we went through a series of dynamic stretch, trying to go through all the muscles in the lower body. So the hip flexors, the glutes, the quads, the hamstrings, the adductors, things that can get tight on Lawrence that can compromise his position for certain events in strongman. Then we saw he was a bit tight through his hip flexors, so we just stretched out the hip flexors. We did a few hip thrusts, just try and get the glutes going to counteract that, and just finished off with some static stretching. So nothing too crazy today. First one back since 5-6 week break.
Well, we've had a long discussion about what I kind of need to improve on. The last couple of years I've kind of been progressing again, I've been hitting PBs, but there's still loads of weaknesses there, and you know, this is an area that needs addressing. So.
And I think, like you recapped earlier on the mat there, it's I think this Worlds just gone was your first competition or first Worlds you've been injury free.
Yeah.
I think that lack of mobility has been a big reason for that, you know, you've been getting injured a lot. So that was nice to see, you had a competition where you didn't get injured, and touch wood, carry that forward and build on it.
Yeah, thank you for today, buddy.
All right,
see you soon. And food. So, mobility and conditioning done with Harry. Pretty basic, just cardio stuff today. Just got my heart rate up to about between 130 and 140. And then lots of various different types of stretching. I don't want to turn the air conditioning down because it's bloody hot out there today. We're gonna get some food. And then we're off to Staverton to see this new physio, Tim. Had a little chat with him, but I'm looking forward to meeting him and seeing what he can do. He wants to go through my kind of injury, my past injuries, my focuses and my goals over the next few months. Hopefully he's pretty good. I'll let you guys know if he is. If anyone's in the area, you can look him up. Obviously, the people we've seen so far today, Angus Nixon, is in Bristol. He's an absolutely fabulous chiropractor. Anyone I've ever taken to see him just kind of talks, you know, really good things about him. He's definitely helped me. And obviously, we've just seen my brother in Cheltenham. Not being biased, he's a very, very good coach. You know, I'm sure you can imagine what kind of siblings can be like with each other. But whenever I train with him, I just listen to him. You know, when I said I want him training me, I took him on as a coach, not just as my brother helping me out. And you know, what he says goes. So it's all good. We're having a nice day. We're going to go get some food and then on to the next place.
I recognise your face.
I was sports therapist at Forest Green when you were training at the Aggie College.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah. I had a quick chat with Gus yesterday.
Yeah.
He said you're doing okay.
Yeah, I saw him today. I saw him this morning, which was good because
okay.
I hadn't seen him for about 6 weeks.
Yeah.
Just through competing at Worlds and then I had another comp and then I've been away 2 weeks in Jamaica getting married.
Oh,
so it's been a nice break, but I'm going to back into serious training now.
Yeah.
I failed a number of his tests this morning, but he's kind of manipulated me and sorted me out.
So positive reactions.
Yeah, I've just been training actually in Cheltenham, just mobility stuff and conditioning. Tends to have Wednesday as like a recovery day anyway.
Okay, good.
So it kind of works out pretty well. But yeah, certain things, I mean, I'll go through a list of injuries if you want.
I need to know because I want to work out how we're going to work together.
Yeah.
So if there's...
Well, I'll kind of go through the things that I want to improve on. I mean, something I'm working with Gus and with my coach is improving my mobility. That's something...
So number one...
Particularly in the glute area, hips and glutes, and the shoulders.
Yeah, Gus mentioned shoulders about pressing.
Yeah. But probably glutes more than anything. Kind of
why
the
glutes?
So tight, honestly. Just being, obviously, getting in that kind of effective position to be powerful.
Yeah.
I have the strength there, but the mobility almost lets me down sometimes.
In what perspective? As in deep squats?
Deep squats aren't so much of an issue, but things like Atlas stones, where we're kind of like, you're trying to get, I mean, ideally, for me to be in the strongest position to lift Atlas stones, I've got to be getting my feet kind of in that narrow, and get my hands on the floor, but as you can see from that, my mobility is shit. So I tend to go quite wide to get my hands under,
so
and then automatically put myself in like a weaker position when you transition into, I mean, ideally you want to be kind of in that half squat, almost like a front squat position.
We're almost growing mobility there as opposed to hip.
Yeah.
Because what we need you to have is, because I know you're a fan of Kelly Starrett.
I'm a fan of anything. I don't ever dismiss kind of anything. I'm always
open book.
Yeah.
So you need the capacity of if you're down in a squat here.
Yeah.
We need the capacity to
open up the hip. Yeah.
Open up your hips without losing the integrity of strength.
Yeah.
Within you know your hips, your back, and everything else. So when you're down here, I understand. As soon as you go here.
Yeah.
You lose all your torque. You lose all your power.
Yeah.
What we need to do is get you there and look at everything. It might, you know, what your ankle's like.
Bad.
Yeah.
Calves are very tight.
So
hamstrings are everything's shit.
Straight away, if you haven't got the capacity of dorsiflexion there, you've got to compromise elsewhere. So when you squat, do you ever feel like you want to go backwards like that?
When I'm squatting with big weights and in my Olympic shoes, my squatting's not so much of an issue. But to squat now in just a normal pair of shoes, I'd fall back.
Yeah. So do you understand why, but then explains why that would be?
No.
So Olympic shoes, are yours quite wedged?
Yeah, there's a wedge on them.
Yeah, so you always see people in the gym with big discs underneath their heels. It's easy for us to
go up on your toes,
cheat into that, and that's what an Olympic shoe does.
Yeah.
People think they're great. I prefer barefoot. I know you probably deadlift barefoot.
Yeah, I do.
Because
you
want that integrity with the ground. But with that, if you haven't got great dorsiflexion, that's just a real cheap way of...
Yeah.
Of getting down there. So we need to work on ankle mobility, definitely.
Yep.
And say, right, okay, improve that. How does it feel? So we do lots of test, retest, and go, right, try this. How does it feel?
Yep.
Do you use phosphans at all?
I have in the past. I haven't used them recently.
Any joy?
I guess.
And what regions?
Elbows, knees, ankles.
Yeah.
Just I was suffering with my elbows quite badly at the time, and they seemed to work pretty well for helping get a lot of blood in the area. And recently, I haven't had any or no major elbow issues, so
Yeah, touch wood.
Yeah, good. Perfect. Okay, so what, apart from mobility, so hips and shoulders.
Yep.
Similar sort of story with shoulders. Just feel like you haven't got
rotation and kind of, you know, if you look at me now, kind of get stuck about there. It's
so we got
very bad, and it'll actually help my squat if I can get in a tighter position. I can squat very wide. I want to be able to get the bar tighter.
You want to be able to retract as well. So shoulders wise.
Shoulder rotation is.
So
awful.
So what we do is then I was leaving this as a sort of open session to. I didn't know what you were going to bring.
Yeah.
What we'll do is we're assess, we look at ankles, we analyze sort of squat movement as well. We look at your shoulders, and then apply. It depends how you want to work.
Yeah.
In terms of, do you just want to focus on a session is just shoulders, or are we looking at trying to attack the whole thing?
We'll see what like time we've got and you know what we can look at. I mean, there's so much to work on.
That's what I mean.
I want another area is just built up scar tissue from injuries that need to work. You know, so
yeah, that's fine. So, what areas have we got scar tissue?
Bicep, tricep, forearms, quads, hamstrings.
So, what we need to do is what I've kind of devised here is, so I get an idea of what you're doing to yourself.
Yep.
Is sort of a training schedule if you know one.
Yeah. So Monday's back and deadlifts and sit back assistance work.
Okay. What? How many sessions?
On Monday.
Yeah.
One. Weightlifting session, and then in the mornings when I can and I'm not working, I do a gentle cardio mobility session. So AM, just 20 minutes, get my heart rate between 120 and 140.
Yeah.
And then 40 minutes working on mobility. This is kind of like a new routine that's just started last week, so
that's
okay. Fresh into it.
It takes time. So where are you getting your mobility work from?
It's just. A set routine that's planned out for me by my brother, and I have to just go through certain movements.
Good.
Foam rolling as well,
stuff
like that.
Okay. So what was Monday again? You said back?
Monday is back and assistance work. So it's normally hamstring work actually to start with, and then deadlifts, a deadlift variation, some kind of rowing movement, and maybe a little bit of bicep work, but tends to be more like hammer curls rather than just focusing on.
Sure. Tuesdays?
Tuesday's a pressing session, so overhead pressing, bench pressing, some kind of dumbbell or machine press, a little bit of rotator cuff work and rear delts.
Good. Okay, anything else?
Nope.
Just one session? Are we predominantly looking at one session a day?
Monday, Tuesday, Thursday and Friday I try to do the mobility and cardio in the morning, but due to schedule it doesn't always work out.
Okay, fine. Mobility Thursday and Friday?
Yeah.
You're seeing Gus once a week?
Yeah, sometimes twice a week when he can fit me in.
Yeah, he's a busy man. Okay, fine. Wednesdays?
Wednesdays is, I see Gus in the morning. I see my brother at lunchtime, which is, again, conditioning a little bit more. It varies each session, but like a little bit more vigorous. Like often strongman events, can try and condition myself for, you know, like shield carries or drags and stuff like that.
Yeah, sure.
With more mobility work. I find on my own I can't get into certain positions, so he'll like force me into positions, hold me.
That's what you need, so you need a little bit.
Just because there's so much muscle there and the mobility's so bad, I can get in a position. If I can't have someone holding it, it'll like ping out of position.
Just like an elastic spring. Okay, Thursdays?
Thursdays is my leg session, so squats. Normally looking at possibly some moving events as well, like yoke or frame.
Okay, fine.
Leg press, perhaps. I don't tend to do much like bodybuilding stuff. I wouldn't spend loads of time doing isolation movements and leg extensions.
More
stuff
functional.
Like that. Yeah.
You're a functional man. Okay, Friday. Yoke's your forte, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm very good at like moving events in general, particularly like for speed.
Yeah.
Anything involving.
What's the key to that success, do you think?
Powerful hips. Although my glutes are so kind of tight and I have those mobility issues, they're very, very powerful.
Good.
And I've always been quite explosive and athletic, even maybe not looking it, but I was always good at 100 meter sprints. And
perfect. Friday?
My next session is either Friday, Saturday or Sunday, depending on my schedule again.
That's fine.
But it's more of a pressing session, so more of an explosive pressing session, push pressing with some kind of strongman implement. At the moment it's a lot because that's kind of what I've got in September. And then strongman events, focusing again more on technique and conditioning rather than necessarily heavy weights.
Okay.
They're still moderately heavy, to be fair, but it's more technical work and speed.
Okay. So we're busy.
Yep.
We're busy. So mobility-wise, I think that's where we need to...
That's the area that I feel can help me improve quicker than anything else.
Yeah. So I think that with that, and I'm here to be a little bit of a drill sergeant when I need to be.
Yeah.
With mobility, once you get it, you got to keep it.
Of course. Yeah.
So
I was working quite hard on mobility for probably 3 months up to Worlds this year.
Yeah.
And it was improving slowly, you know, nothing drastic, but there was good noticeable improvement.
Yeah.
And then I've had like 5-6 weeks off.
Yeah.
And I feel like I've taken a big step back.
Yeah. Because you've got motion is lotion, rest is rust.
Yeah.
You know, if you're not tapping into these end ranges of where we need you to be.
Yeah.
You're never ever going to have that capacity. So. People laugh when I do this, but I liken mobility to a dog or a cat. If you ever look at a dog or a cat, they've always got every range of motion that they need.
Yeah.
If you pick up a cat from the scruff of the neck,
yeah.
It will always have that scruff of skin.
Yeah.
And we should have the capacity to grab skin wherever we want.
Yeah.
But we get so tight and knotted down. So if you straighten your leg for me,
yeah.
you know, we're not grabbing a great deal there.
Yeah.
So fascially, you know, really, really tight, and that's gonna be a factor. But then we can tap into hydration. You know, are you looking at salts? And there's loads that we can help you with. I want to take our time, get a real detailed plan of where you're at.
Yep.
So you've got, is it Giants you've got coming up in September?
Yeah, September. End of September is the Giants Live World Tour Finals and Deadlift World Championships. It's all part of the same competition.
So that's the same. Because they usually do that like at Leeds.
Yeah, they did the deadlift at Leeds last year. This year, they've put it into Manchester. And they're doing it slightly differently. Rather than doing deadlift for max, they're doing 400 kilos for reps. Which
okay.
is just ridiculous.
Okay. What's deadlifting like at the moment?
My deadlifting is probably... I haven't maxed out for a while, but I guess around 420.
Okay.
My best ever is 435, but I tore my lat going for 436.
I've never seen
and since then, I've not managed to get... back to that kind of level. Everything else has improved, but my deadlift's gone backwards.
But that's going to have a big impact on your shoulder.
Yeah.
So you look at where your lat lives and where it goes into, so into that bicipital groove of your arm. If you've got previous injury there, scar tissue, mobility, it's not going to want
to. I do notice, like especially like on a colder day, if I'm rolling it, it takes a while to kind of ease up.
Yeah.
It's definitely tighter on that side.
Yeah. What surgical?
I haven't had any surgery on any of the muscle tears.
No. Is there a bicep?
Yeah. Bicep's partial. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tricep was more kind of. I went up to a guy in Middlesbrough.
Okay.
Who kind of specialises in upper limbs.
Yeah.
And the way that the muscles tore, he said it would be detrimental to try and do surgery.
Okay.
Because it was almost like spaghetti kind of tearing rather than kind of like a clear.
Yeah. So you had quite good fragmentation across.
Yeah.
As opposed to it just being split.
Yeah.
Okay. Fine. Right. So if we start off with hips, mobility wise, so we look at flexion, extension, rotation internal, left and right, and then external. Yeah, I say I've left this just to see where the session goes. Not
cool. Yeah, yeah.
And then ankles are definitely need to look at.
Ankles are bad, definitely. I often, if I try and stretch my hamstrings, it'll often be my calf that hurts.
Your calf hurts,
yeah.
So if you want a treatment today, we're going to give you treatment. What would be the prep? What would be your number one go-to?
Probably my glutes, to be honest, because they're so involved in squatting, deadlifting, big power movements. Calves, always tight on me.
Yeah, I think that's where...
Maybe my lats as well.
Yeah.
Looking at. And if we had time, shoulders, triceps, kind of areas.
Okay, fine. I've got all the time in the world.
Cool.
So it's a question of what you guys can do.
I'm fine.
If we pop shoes and socks off.
Yep.
First things first, let's look at dorsiflexion of your foot. I'll get you to stand near the door because I need a flat surface. What I'm going to get you to do is...
push the leg forward.
Yeah. You've done these before.
Yep.
So if you do it next to the door, because you get the data rail out of the way. So try and keep your heel in contact with the floor. Not bad. Good.
To move it back slightly.
Yeah, just drop it back just a touch. Good. And again, just keep bringing it back. Yeah, good there. And again. Just keep it straight.
So now it's starting to get a bit tight.
Yeah, where's that man? Is that feeling down through the Achilles here?
Just like slightly higher. Yeah,
yeah. Through that tendon junction. So you're able to touch the door?
Yeah. And now it's getting a bit harder. Just about.
Okay, to keep your foot there for a second. Scientific piece of equipment, a pen.
Yep.
Okay, and switch legs. So you look tighter there already.
Yeah.
That heel's starting to raise a touch.
Yeah, that's tight.
Yeah. So you're not a million miles off of each ankle.
Yeah.
But there's definitely a restriction. Okay. Can you show me a full squat? Right. Are you okay with me taking a picture?
Yeah.
Yeah. Come back up. So I'd like to show visually what I see, because you can't see yourself.
Yeah, of course.
So go down into a full squat. How long do you reckon you can stay there for?
Not very long before I fall over.
Okay. Where are you feeling that?
Calves.
Yeah. Anything through the knee?
No, my knee feels fine. Tightness in the calves. I feel like if I was to sit back more into
you're gonna
go. Gonna fall back.
Yeah. So that correlates perfectly with having that lack of ankle dorsiflexion.
Yeah.
If you haven't got the capacity to get over there like this, to lean back,
yeah,
because you haven't got that range, you're going to go. What I'm seeing with your feet here.
Sorry, my feet are disgusting.
No, don't worry about that. Look at how externally rotated you are.
Yeah.
Now that's a compensatory way for your body to allow you to go down.
To get down, yeah.
If I say,
if
to
I was to keep my toes pointed forward, I wouldn't get down. I'd be like, even like to here, I'm starting to kind of feel like I'm going to fall.
Yeah. Now, I'm not going to say I want you perfectly straight.
Yeah.
Because anatomically, in your hips, that might not even be possible.
Yeah.
So there has to be an element of rotation, but you definitely probably don't want to be somewhere around
yeah.
there.
When I squat normally, I have a slight turnover. But that's in my Olympic shoes.
Okay.
Whereas even that, I will struggle to kind of squat down to.
Go.
I mean, when I squat, I actually sit back first, but without the heels on, I just feel like I'm going to fall over.
Yeah, but we can improve that. Yeah. So that's not just calf, that's ankle as well. Okay. And you're relatively flat-footed as well.
I should imagine I am. I didn't used to be, but being my body weight, it's probably got worse over the years.
Yeah. So I'd like to try and implement some exercise to get you strong
okay.
in there. The one thing that Starrett talks about is generating torque in the hip.
Yeah.
So when you're in that squat position, I don't know if you do this, but
yeah, you rotate so it tightens up. Yeah.
Locking. Do you do that as a
yeah,
when you're eventing anyway?
Yeah, it's something I've kind of experimented with.
Any joy
in the past?
Which was awesome.
Yeah. I think when you kind of go to the level that I lift at. Things change.
Yeah, as yeah. No,
what
yeah.
you do to like the kind of average lifter.
Yeah.
But yeah, certainly in certain things, like on my bench, I kind of rotate around and get like the elbows to tighten up.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're kind of tightening up the joints. And
so you're generating torque.
Yeah.
And that's my theory
yeah.
behind that.
It's like
you're
putting your feet in sand and kind of twisting them.
Yeah.
To create that tension.
Listen, I understand if you deadlift and there's like a little bit of that when you're lifting 400 kg. You've got to get that.
Yeah, it's everyone's built differently, so
yeah.
in terms of lifting. But I mean, one thing I'm going to look at from someone deadlifting is how their lower back is, not so much how their upper back is, but
yeah.
if you're rounding at the
yeah.
if you're hinging, then you're going to fall into
a butt wink, as we call it, a butt wink.
Yeah, that's not so effective. But
yeah.
I see some people that you watch, like Andy Bolton, he's actually kind of rounded in his shoulders,
yeah.
but his lower back is as tight as fuck.
Yeah, so he's got that hip explosiveness
yeah.
through his glutes.
Yeah.
yeah. Perfect, right. So, ankles and calves, not too bad, but definitely we can improve.
Yeah.
Can we just rotate away? I just want to have a look at the back of your heels. So you kind of just, footballers get it really, really bad.
Yeah.
You get like this lump of bone
okay.
on the outside here. Now yours isn't overly bad. Some people, it can look a bit like an egg.
Almost like it's protruding out the back.
Yeah. And so have you ever heard of Osgood Slatters?
I have heard of it, yeah.
When you get the lump of bone at the front there. It's a similar sort of process with the Achilles. Again, it's where you haven't got capacity to do that. And coming back to this again, it's so important.
Yeah.
When you start walking and squatting with like in this action, your Achilles pulls off axis.
Yeah.
The body senses that, so it lays down like an extra lump of bone to compensate. Yeah. Well, if that's where the load's going.
Yeah.
So instead of the load being nice and straight and into that calcaneus there, it lays down bone to the side of it to sort of compensate for what you're putting it through.
Yeah.
And you know, you're a big lad, you're lifting big things.
Yeah.
That could quickly sort of, you know, it's a weakness.
Yeah.
You know, but that's present in a lot of people. So we'll definitely get some mobility through your ankle.
Yep.
Through the calves. Right. Shoulders. This should be fun. Right. Let's get you standing. Just actively now from there. Just rotate as far back as you can. Or you're already there. You're already there.
Awful.
Okay. Try and keep it 90 degrees. Now rotate down. So do you feel how you have to elevate to sort of just get yourself?
Yeah. The compensation is through my back and, you know, upper back as well.
Yeah. How's the things through the thoracic spine?
The spine's okay.
You feel like you've got mobility there? Gus,
yeah.
There's some stuff there. Okay. Let's get you on the bed then. And then, so, we lie on our back, head on the pillow.
Or top off, or?
Keep it on for now, so I'm just looking at ranges.
On the back, sorry.
Yes, please. It's better than Gus's bed, isn't it?
Yeah.
A little lining board that kind of practice have. So, this is the lat.
This
is the bicep.
Most things are on the right-hand side, which is not surprising.
Okay, fine. So,
because my bicep was the first injury I ever got, a serious injury.
Yeah.
The doctors really didn't know what to do at the time in Cheltenham. Yeah. So they said, they were kind of saying, if they were operated on, I could lose my grip strength and stuff like that. And at the time, I wasn't very pushy. I was kind of new to it. Just took their word for it.
Yeah.
If it happened again, I would have got it operated on. But I think it's, you know, that compensation has affected so many things on the one side.
Yeah. So there's a nerve thing. For me to push you there, what do you feel?
It's okay. It's not agony or anything.
But that's
like, I wouldn't be able to do that on my own.
Yeah. And we're not even at 90 degrees, so probably
no.
Sort of 70 degrees.
Yeah.
And then externally, again.
Tight, yeah.
Where do you feel that?
Elbow and into the front belts, I guess.
It does go.
Weirdly, my elbow's a bit funny when you're doing that at the moment.
What's going on there?
Just a slight tender feeling.
Is that something? Is that just popular? Injury, do you think? Or like, have you done any sort of pressing work and aggravated it? Or?
No. Just.
No. You think this side's your better side?
Not necessarily better, although it felt better going down.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, not fantastic there. So again, you'd probably push you to an 80, but that's a bit of effort.
So you want to be at 90 at least, don't you?
Yeah, parallel to the beds, but keeping that there. So what I'm looking for is whether this shoulder sort of wants to jump forward, sort of cheat itself to get into those ranges. How does that feel there?
It's tight.
Where's that tight?
Just in here.
All through?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. But no, definitely this side's your better side, but it's external rotation and you need that to be able to...
Yeah, to press overhead, to get a strong position,
overhead.
To hold the bar, to squatting.
Yeah.
Because I can hold wide when I squat and you lose that tension in your back, whereas if I can get the bar in tighter and keep my upper back tighter, I feel like I lift more.
Yeah, definitely. Right down here,
yeah.
I want you to lie on the bed. But I want to be able to get your arms up above your head, so up here.
So you want my head that way?
I want your head, head towards me.
Yep.
On your back, but you're going to be scooted right down the bottom. Perfect. That's the one. Okay. So take it nice and steady. Yeah. Tight.
Another thing we probably see about a torn labrum in this shoulder.
Okay.
So that's another reason, probably this side's slightly worse. But.
Okay, fine. I'm going to let your shoulders drop.
Yeah.
Don't adjust. Okay? I don't think they're going to drop at all. I think they're just going to stay exactly where they are. Okay. So, lat tightness, yes. Pec tightness, yes. You're not perfectly straight on the bed, but I shouldn't be able to get my hand underneath here.
Yeah.
Not so bad there. This side, if the bed was there, there's
yeah.
a definite
yeah.
gap. And you've got this bend in the elbows,
yeah.
which shows where your lats go. It's pulling you back down.
Mm-hmm.
I won't go too crazy on that side, but we should be
yeah.
somewhere up there. And what do you feel there? Pinching in the shoulder?
Yeah, yeah.
Or across the pec?
All three kind of areas. Tight lats as you push down, you can feel them stretching. Shoulders and chest,
yeah.
definitely. The pecs kind of pulling.
Yeah.
And the shoulders, just slight pinching, really.
Yeah. So there's loads of work to be done.
Yeah.
But positive work.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know,
no, it's why
you're doing well as it is.
Yeah.
You're one of that small percentage of the
that's,
strongest
that's
men.
What we're kind of looking at. It's why.
Let's get yourself out of
this. I've kind of decided this year. I'm focusing on as much recovery work as possible. I'm kind of performing at the top level anyway. If I can improve that, you know, 3-4%,
that's massive. Yeah.
And it's, I know most big strong guys are bad anyway, but I'm even bad for them in terms
yeah.
of the mobility side of things.
Yeah.
So it's definitely affecting me, and I'm still doing okay.
It's got to become a habitual
yeah.
habit
yeah, yeah.
of you working your mobility.
Yeah, no, I know. It's kind of, you know. That's why we're looking at every day if we can doing
yeah.
mobility work,
good.
Treatments, you know.
Okay.
Every.
Where do we start?
Where do you think? what needs the most work?
Let's. There's stuff to be done everywhere. Let's.
Yeah, that's how I feel.
Let's symptomatic. Let's do one calf and ankle first.
Yep.
And then what we do is we get you up off the table and do
see.
A retest.
Yep. Okay.
See how you feel, and then obviously we jump onto the other side. I don't want you then going out here squatting.
Yeah.
One-sided, level you out. I think we're going to see massive improvement in your shoulders because it's you're doing all the right stuff in terms of strength work, but to regain mobility through there, I can do some powerful things.
Cool.
I do a lot of the.
Anything you think will
instrument-assisted massage.
Yeah, he was. He's used a bit of these with me in the past. Gus has himself.
Yeah.
To consider it's quite good. Feels like
powerful.
Powerful.
And yeah. And that shouldn't be.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Well, that's what it's all.
So that's tissue quality, but we can get into that.
Cool.
And then floss bands. So what I will like to do is work through those calves, work through the ankle, floss band the ankle, get into some movements, reassess, better, worse.
Cool.
So,
we'll
okay.
see how it is.
So let's get that central. Okay, if we lie face down. Yeah, I saw on Facebook that you worked with your brother over it. Is it Prince of Wales?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. It's a good facility, to be fair.
Yeah,
getting on the track.
It was great today. It was like,
bend your knees.
So nice.
Drop down.
Although he took me inside, to be fair, today.
Oh, what?
He's like, we're not doing anything outside.
Doing anything in this 27 degree heat
yeah.
we get once in a blue moon. And that's key.
Yeah.
If you're banging your head going, I'm the best I can be.
No, I definitely
you know,
feel I can get better.
That's a really important thing.
I think one of the things that held me back is having 4 years of being injured.
Yeah, you've had a rough time with it.
Yeah. And that's why I've had to like now reevaluate things.
Because you went through that phase where you got actually a little bit shredded.
Well, I wouldn't say shredded, but I got in
I don't know,
decent lost, shape.
You dropped quite a bit.
Yeah, I got to the point where you could see abs on a good day.
See,
but it wasn't effective in terms of performance because I was too light.
Now I know you're probably thinking this is a bit soft.
No, obviously, like sometimes when people have gone like stupidly hard, it's always been detrimental.
No, I'm right. Good. So
I'm not like some hard guy trying to.
No.
You know, I've had plenty of massage before, and sometimes when people go too hard, I don't like it because it almost just beats me up for too long.
Yeah, I'm not a butcher, so I'm here to work with you as a team. So if anything's too funky,
yeah.
we back off. Because if you tighten up and you're not you're not here to enjoy yourself.
No, we're here to get better, that's what
yeah.
I'm here for.
But if you're not relaxed and letting me do what I need to do,
yeah.
I might as well massage the wall.
Yeah.
Because you're just not gonna let me get into those tissues and make change. So we'll get into it progressively and then strip through your ankle. Where do you train at Swindon?
Baseball Pro Strength and Fitness.
Is that tight through there?
Yeah, that's tight. Super calf.
Just having a little bit of a feel around, so.
Yeah.
What time's your session tomorrow? Do you ever do anything early, early?
No, it's normally around 5-ish.
Tight through there?
Yeah, not as bad as the other side, but definitely tight.
Fine. Right.
My cuffs are always tight. Anytime I get the massage, they hurt.
Yeah, it's, pardon the pun, but it's everyone's Achilles heel.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to use my scraper a little bit just to see
what's
going on. So what I'm looking for here, I know you said Gus has done it, but just to reiterate, I'm looking for any sort of big areas of redness that flare up.
Yep.
That kind of shows to me that's a go-to area for sort of maybe there's possible adhesions there.
Okay.
You know, I don't truly believe like the way these things are marketed that this breaks down scar tissue.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It makes you a new man. I just think it's a nice little add-on.
Yeah.
And it gives me a little bit of feedback that my hands don't. But I prefer my hands.
You know, it's a tool, isn't it?
Yeah. Just lift this leg and rest it down. Right, now we're getting to work. See what's going on in here. But remember, it's got to be within your tolerance.
Yep.
How do you feel through there?
It's tight, it's okay though.
Good. Now what I did have in mind was looking at times when we can do this, that if we want to go really, really heavy, and
yeah.
I mean, give you a good battering,
yeah.
How you can recover from it. So if you were going to train early tomorrow morning,
probably like a Friday or something would be best.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Tight for there. Too much?
No, it's okay.
At that point there.
Yeah, I can feel that.
Just have a sort of up and down movement with your foot. That changes it a bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, a bit worse.
See, I'm a big fan of trying to get things moving better with movement. Just relax. I don't want you lying there like a big piece of meat.
No.
And just letting me do what I need to do.
Yeah, it's like while you're holding that trigger point, as I was moving, it started to ease up.
Yeah, good. Another one there. How's that?
Lovely.
What was the weather like in Botswana? Was it too hot?
No, it was okay. So Botswana's quite like a dry heat.
Okay.
So it's like 25 to 30 degrees. Nothing terrible. When it was in Malaysia a few years back, it was like 40 degrees and 100% humidity.
No.
That was awful.
Not for me, that.
No, that's too much. But Botswana was okay. It's just boring there, there's nothing to do, and you're there for 2 weeks.
Well, one of my friends was out there working, James.
I know James.
Yeah.
He's treated me a little bit as well, actually, in the past. Yeah, it was his first year there.
A sore through there?
I can feel that. It's not agony or anything, but I can certainly feel it's not right.
Good. So this is the very, very top of the capsule of your ankle.
Yeah.
And it can get quite, I don't overly like the word fibrotic, but it kind of is, that is the right word.
Yeah.
It just gets really stiff around the back here. And where it attaches to the Achilles, you know, like I said, we should be able to move muscles. They want to glide on top of each other.
Yeah.
It's just restoring that motion. So we'll start getting into this a bit deeper, if we weren't already deep enough. again, it's too much to say. How's that?
That's okay.
Okay.
Yep.
So I'm going to hit this outside one a bit more. You're not going to like me.
I like most people, you're right.
How's that?
It's okay, yeah. I've been known to swear at that.
No, you go for it. Is that too much?
No, it's okay. You'll know when it's too much because I tend to really tighten up.
Yeah.
I try and stay as relaxed as possible.
No, that's good. But like I say, I want to work together.
Yeah.
Just because you're a big man.
Yeah.
And you do big, lift big things, doesn't mean that pressure doesn't hurt.
No, exactly. It's still just flesh and bone, you know.
Yeah, of course.
Same as anyone else.
How's that through the Achilles?
Yeah, I can feel it.
Too much?
No, it's easing up as you go up the layer.
Right, I want to strip through this Achilles with my little tool.
Okay.
Now, if we bend our leg, so as I'm combing through, I just want you to bring your foot up and push all the way down. Yeah, you got it. Sore?
Yeah.
Too much?
No, it's okay.
See, another issue we've got to think about with you is soft tissue to soft tissue blocks.
Yeah.
You know, a guy of your size, you've got this big calf, this big hamstring.
Yeah.
They're going to naturally meet in the middle.
Yeah.
A lot quicker.
Yeah.
You know, so that's what we call a soft tissue to soft tissue block. So with your mobility, we've got to be a little bit mindful of.
Yeah.
You know, you may not.
Yeah. I mean, you know, the goal for me is to be functionally performing at a good level. I don't care about being the most flexible person in the world.
No, but if we can get 1%, 2%, 3%
yeah.
incrementally, is that too much?
No.
Your voice says otherwise.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely happy.
Yeah, no, I'm fine.
Yeah.
I'm used to, you know, getting treatment. It's not pleasant, you know, but
no.
I don't care about not pleasant, I care about performing better.
Yeah, definitely. Sore there?
Yeah.
Just have a little twiddle of your foot. Lift up the toes as well. Good. Easier?
Yeah.
There.
Yeah, it's tight.
Okay, again, just a little bit of movement with the foot. Okay. So, in terms of the calf, we'll leave it at that.
Yep.
But what I want to do is turn you over and then work into the ankle. So, what we need to do, Lawrence, is turn over onto your back, pillow, and then if you shuffle down a bit so your foot's hanging off the end. Knee feel okay there?
Yeah.
So, it's okay to work through the calf,
yeah,
and get mobility and trigger points and everything else through there. There's soft tissue around the ankle as well.
Okay.
And we need, I don't know if you've had sort of capsular work done.
No, I haven't actually.
You know, if this capsule is stiff and tight, which it probably is in your shoulders as well.
Yeah.
We've got to get mobility back into the tissues.
Yeah.
So when you do your mobility work, my biggest fault, you know, why I like to educate people.
Yeah.
If you've got tight muscles, they tend to stretch quite quick,
yeah,
in my opinion. What doesn't stretch quick are the structures of like the hip joint. So the capsule around there, the capsule around the shoulder, and the capsules around here.
Yeah.
unfortunately, you need to stretch those for long, slow periods to make change.
Okay.
And that's where a lot of people tend to go wrong. We stretch muscles, we smash muscles with rollers and bands,
yeah.
And, but we don't look at, you know, what surrounds a joint. There's, you know, there is soft tissue around there.
Yeah.
Any soreness through there?
I can feel a little bit. There's nothing to that.
Any soreness on the inside there?
Tiny bit. More towards the back. That's it. Right in there.
More through there.
Yeah. When Angus kind of gave me a number, you know, I'm always interested in ways of improving.
Yeah, definitely. Again, just a little bit of...
So people have proper, focused goals.
And that's what I wanted, you know, that's what I've got written down on my sheet. What are your goals? What's your... Because if you've got something to focus on, it makes it that much easier to do your work.
Yeah, definitely.
Got to get that stimulus in. Yeah. You haven't got strong by thinking about I'm going to be strong.
No, of course.
You've got strong over years because you're still young in the sport, aren't you?
I'm not old. I'm kind of, you know, I've got a few more years yet. You can feel old sometimes when you get these young 20-year-olds kind of come in. And
yeah, sure.
My training partner the other day told me he was born in 1998.
Oh, don't.
And I was just looking at him thinking, what?
I was in secondary school at that point.
I left in... 99. Yeah, okay.
Was in your 10. So capsular, that's the soft tissue side of it then. What I want to do, I'm not a chiropractor, I'm not an osteopath,
yep.
Sports therapist, but I can mobilise joints,
yep.
Okay, and that's what I want to do with your ankle. So I want to take it into regions where it just doesn't go unless someone like me turns up,
okay.
And gives it a bit of movement. So, fix you there, nice and relaxed. I'm going to draw, so I'm going to push down with my right,
yep.
And draw with my left.
Okay.
Now you've got some nice anterior draw there. Can you feel that move?
Yep. Is that good?
Yeah. Good. It's moving nicely. Any pain there?
No.
So again, just making sure everything's moving,
yep.
Around that ankle. Couple of things. I'm just gonna sort of, you're gonna relax your leg. I'm gonna flick one way and flick this way,
yep.
Just to sort of loosen everything off on the medial and lateral aspect of your ankle. Any pinchy sensations there?
No.
Good. Side. Okay?
Yeah.
Weird?
Yeah, kind of like, just like on this side of it, just going around there, you're getting a weird kind of sensation.
Okay.
It's just normal.
Again, I'm moving your ankle in regions, it wants to go,
yeah.
Hasn't had the capacity to go. Okay, so this next one, I'm going to lean onto the back of your hamstring here,
yeah.
And then, so from this position, I'll have my knee up here.
Yep. Yeah.
I'm going to distract very gently your ankle.
Okay.
So it's almost going to feel like I'm trying to pull it out of the joint.
Okay.
That's the first part. If I feel like that's okay and it's comfortable, and you report that as well, I'm then going to sort of add a little bit of dorsiflexion,
yeah.
In as well.
No problem.
Okay, so. Anything that?
No, that's fine.
So just hold that for a second. Relax. So you feel it sort of go back?
Yeah, kind of sinks back in.
Yeah. So then we just add a little bit of movement. Good. Relax. You okay with my leg on your hamstring there?
Yeah.
Fine. Okay. So, floss band.
Yep.
Ready for that pain?
Mm-hmm.
If we get you standing, just have a little move around before we put the band on. Big lad. Big band. Yeah. Good warm up.
Mm-hmm.
So this would be good to do prior to squats, deadlifts.
Mm-hmm.
The thing I recommend is if you use it as a warm up, because that gives you the mobility, then go and practice the mobility. Go do it with weight, because then it sort of gets honed into the body a bit better. Okay, so. Rest your foot over there. Just drop your leg down a bit. That's it. So if you get any of that crazy numb feeling,
mm-hmm.
you let me know. Feel okay?
Yep.
It's not every day someone wraps you up in latex.
No.
Okay, let's get you standing. I just want you to promote dorsiflexion, so whether you want to do that in terms of squats, so if you want to squat for a bit, or if you just want to do like a little lunge forward, really try and get that knee over. It's probably the only time I'm happy for you to sort of break form and yank it up a bit. And don't be afraid to load up onto this side and then really get over, really push into it. So get into a squat if you want,
yep.
and then lean over to this side. Really push the boundaries. How's it feel? Tight?
Yeah, it's tight. Oh, sorry.
How's the toes? Numb?
They're okay.
Another minute if we can tolerate it. Anything more, just that dorsiflexion, you know, practice knee towards. So what we're doing here is we're getting that compressive force completely around the ankle, but when you apply movement, we're sort of plying those tissues apart and causing them to slide better. Good, another 35 seconds, long 35 seconds. Now we haven't touched the groin, I think there's work to be done in the groin.
Yep.
We've just purely focused on ankle and calf. What we're doing is we're assessing seconds how that transfers into a functional movement.
Yep.
15 seconds. How's it foot?
It's okay.
That's it, really load up, get it over. So, you know, that's limited the blood flow to your ankle.
Yeah.
So us taking this off now, it's going to flow back in. Now, that's ischemic pressure, which is a bit like a trigger point. You kind of deprive the area of blood flow. Neurally, it sort of calms down. You take your thumb off. Theory is, it should stay relaxed.
Yeah.
And that's what
feels
we should.
Nice now.
Feels nice now.
Yeah.
Good. Right, let's get you standing. Let's have a look at another squat. So it worked out there for you. Stand, sit, stand, sit, stand. So, see what that does. How does that feel to you?
Feels alright. This feel, leg feels tighter, definitely.
The foot position is probably a touch better on this side, but there's, you know, we haven't really tapped into the final mechanics of it. Again, freeze frame there. So go back into that position, do what you do. So stand up without moving your foot, but look at the position you're in.
Yeah.
So, you know, so we're sort of externally rotated. So you're looking for that cheat.
Yeah.
To get dorsiflexion, we need to make sure we're straighter, but that yanks it up. But that's going to come with fine tuning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we just finished my treatment here with Tim from Bespoke Treatment. Feel pretty good, actually. We just focused mainly on my calves and ankle mobility today. Obviously, you know, we had a chat at the start, and I am
terrible with mobility, full stop. It's something I really want to improve. Do you want to tell the guys kind of what we did today and just have a little bit of a recap?
Yeah, so basically we assessed Lawrence and looked at where he's struggling and highlighted a few areas. Shoulders were an issue, but today we talked about squatting. A lot of tightness and restriction around the ankles, so worked into the calves, released off through there and did what we needed to do. Then we looked more into the ankle joints and how stiff you were there. Did loads of soft tissue work around the ankle to free it off. Applied some mobilisation techniques to promote movement. Again, reassessed at the end and an improvement.
Yeah, yeah, no, definitely felt good. I'm looking forward to trying squats tomorrow to see how I'm feeling and implementing some of the kind of warm-up drills you kind of showed me to, you know, I've obviously got, you know, got to keep it up for a prolonged period of time. You're not going to get benefits just instantly, but you know, it's the long course that I'm kind of focused on. But all these kind of little things help, and it's something as an athlete I want to improve on, and it's, you know, it's the top of my agenda really. You know, I know I'm strong, that's not an issue. It's trying to be more effective with the strength that I have, and obviously get stronger, but perform a little bit more effectively, if you like.
Our goal is to get Lawrence moving better, more efficiently. If he can access bigger ranges of motion, he's going to be able to tap into more power and be more explosive. He's an explosive guy as he is, but 2-3% can be the difference, as we spoke about.
Yeah, definitely.
That can, you know, change the way that the outcome of your events.
Brilliant. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Excellent. Nice
to see you again, and tune in next time.